version control in hardware engineering can be quite difficult. And unfortunately, KiCad does not support any kind of version control to create multiple revision of the schematic or the PCB layout. So in this video, we'll see how we can solve this version control problem using Git. Imagine working on a large project where features are constantly added and changed. If it's not tracked at some point, we'll lose a lot of vital information like why was the feature added, why was it removed, and how did it affect the circuit. This is why we need version control, which helps in keeping track of changes made to the design. It's essentially like a database that stores every change made to the design over time. This will include addition, deletion, modification, and everything in between. So working on a large project, whether it's a software or hardware, not using a version control is like missing out on one of the most important tool that a professional needs. There are several popular version control systems, but Git is by far the most famous and the popular one, which is used both in hardware and software engineering. Importantly, it does all the features that we discussed for a version control system. But there is a huge caveat. This version control system works perfectly only on text-based documents. If you add a feature like PDF or an image, it cannot keep track of the features that's added or removed. It can only keep track of the number of revisions that's made. So first, let's try to figure out how KiCad handles its various file extensions like .kicad_sch, .kicad_pcb, etc. When we open any of these files in a text editor like a Notepad or VS Code, we can see all these files are just made of human readable text and there is nothing fancy. If you put some effort and learn what does these text mean and how KiCad generates graphical output based on these text, we can directly perform edits on schematic and PCB layout editor just using the text editor without using KiCad. This is really good because it's very compatible with Git and we can see all the edits made on the text level. It's also possible on the graphical level, but we need to use additional tools along with Git to make that possible, which we'll be seeing in upcoming videos. I hope until now you understand why we need version control and Git. Now let's see how to install and use Git within a Windows machine. To install Git, go to git-sam.com and click on Downloads and here select Windows. Finally select the setup file that's compatible with your machine. Once the download process is done, go through the installation. To finish the setup for Git, we need to enter a username and an email. To do that, launch the Git bash after the installation. Here we can use this command to give the username and this command to set up the email. This completes the Git setup. From here on, we can either use Git bash along with various commands to make changes and track revisions. But it can be a little hard to understand for people who are just getting started. So we'll be using the GUI version that Git offers. Git GUI is way easier to get started for beginners and very easy to understand. So in this video, we'll use Git GUI to understand how Git works and how to use it with KiCad. Git version control works on three stages. First, we have unstaged. In this stage, Git just observes the files that are not tracked or files that are just added in the repository. To make Git aware that we need to track these files, we need to stage it. And this is where usually we might review our work and see if everything is good before making these files or changes into a new revision. Once we finish our review, we can commit these files into a new revision with a meaningful message. And Git will save this as a new revision with a unique hash, which can be used to differentiate or revert back to the previous commits. Now we need to follow this process each time we make a new revision or a change to the circuit. Let's see how it works in action. We'll create a scenario where we are working on a project for a client, where he wants us to create a simple LED circuit with a given specification. So we'll fire up KiCad and start a new project. And we'll try to make this as our initial version for the project, where we have no schematic diagram, nor we have the PCB layout. But currently this is not tracked in any way. So let's open the Git GUI. Now in this Git window, click on Create New Repository. And now select the folder where KiCad has created our project. And then click on Create. This Git window is divided into four sections. On the top left, we'll have all the unstaged files. And on the top right, we have the viewer to see what's inside the files. And on the bottom left, we have the stage files. And on the bottom right, we have the commit message editor, where we can enter a meaningful message before we make a new revision. Currently, you can see we have these unstaged files since we just created a project and we never mentioned Git to track these files. To make Git track these files, click on Stage Changed and then click on S. This will move the files from unstaged to the staged area. Now we can enter a meaningful message here. I'll call this initial commit and then click on commit. This will save the first revision for our project, which has an empty schematic editor and an empty PCB layout. Similarly, I'll create a new commit for each feature I add to the circuit. I'll start with creating a simple LED and the resistor circuit. I'll save this circuit and click on rescan to detect the changes and then click on stage changed. And finally, I'll add a meaningful message and click on commit. Now, similarly, let's add a switch to the circuit. Finally, I'll add a battery to the circuit and perform a fourth commit. In case we did not use Git at this point, we have to either delete the battery, print a PDF, then add the battery again. Or we have to duplicate the project just like how we did in the KiCad series. But luckily, we made every revision using Git. So go to Git and click on repository on the menu bar. And under here, select visualize mains history. This will have the list of commits that are performed and also it will point to the current version or the revision that we are at. Since the client wants only the LED, resistor and switch, I'll select the third commit where we don't have the battery. And then copy the first 8 digits of the hash. And close this visualizer window. In the main Git window, click on branch and then select checkout. Here select the option revision expression and paste the 8 digit hash in the text box. And then click on checkout. You will have this pop-up which says this detached checkout. Just click on OK. And here in the bottom we can see the project has been checked out to the previous version. To confirm that, let's close this existing schematic and open it again. Seems like we have successfully went back to the previous version. Let's quickly make a PDF and send it to the client. While the client is reviewing, let's get back to the most recent version. Again, open Git, click on branch, click on checkout, and under this, select local branch and make sure main is selected and click on checkout. And this will get us to the most recent version of the project. To confirm, we can go to the visualizer. Click on repository. Under that, click on visualize mains history. And here we can see the main is pointing to the most recent version with the battery cell added. We can also double check this by going to the KiCad project. I'll close this existing circuit and open the schematic editor again. And you can see we are back to the most recent version of the project. Even here, we can do the changes to the circuit and make a commit. But whenever there is a test or an unsure feature, it's better to create something called as branch. This will help us create a new set of revision without breaking the existing revisions we have. Let's see in action for better understanding. So I'll go to Git and click on branch and under this click on create. And here I'll name the branch as 2_LED_branch and then click on create. This will automatically create a branch and check out to 2LED_branch. If you try the visualizer at this point, we can see both the main and the 2LED branch pointing at the last feature that was added. So I'll add the components as per the specification and make the commits as usual. Since our main branch is untouched, it's pretty easy to go back and get the circuit for one LED plus one battery and set it to the client. Since we are confirmed with the feature branch, we can merge that with the main branch. So go to the main branch and select merge and then click on local merge. And under here, make sure the local branch is selected and select the branch that needs to be merged. In our case, it will be 2_LED_branch and then click on merge. And here we can see I've successfully merged the 2LED branch to the main branch. Now let's see how the version tree has changed after merging the branches together. Go to repository, click on visualize main history. And here we can see the main branch has been updated to the second battery added. So now when I go back to the mains branch, I close this and open the schematic again. And here we can see the main branch has all the features that was added in the second LED branch. Now this process can continue forever throughout the development until the project is satisfied. I hope by this simple example you can understand how powerful version control for hardware engineering can be. Even though throughout the video I used a schematic file for an example, this will perfectly work with the PCB layout file as well. Currently, we barely scratch the surface of using Git. Git is way more powerful when used in software or firmware development, but currently it's limited for circuit design or PCB layout design. So in the upcoming videos, we'll see more advanced concepts in Git along with how to use GitHub and third-party tools for better collaboration. Until then, if you have any questions or doubt, please make sure to ask them at PCBCupid Q&A section. And if you like watching this kind of content, make sure to subscribe to the channel and also share it with people who might be interested in this kind of videos. Until then, keep learning and keep creating.